Oh, San Francisco cable cars. The characters you meet when you're making your way up the hill. At some point I'll tell you this pulley system that they operate on. It's really quite interesting. But in the meantime, hello there. Ralphie here, you malt mighty canyons. Welcome to Whisky Review 157, part of an ongoing series relating to American spirits. And just before while I'm pouring myself a glass, because every review commences with a measure leaving the bottle. Splendid. But before I start nosing and tasting this, I must mention a big thanks to all those Facebookers out there who have been linking up with me since my last review of Elijah Craig 12-year-old. That's over 60 of you have connected with me in Facebook, and I shall not waste your precious time by posting nonsense. I'll let you know when my new reviews surface, and also some lovely pictures of whiskey stuff. Also, got an email from Davin, one of the malt maniacs, and he mentioned that an expert, a very knowledgeable bourbon enthusiast, who I should recommend to yourselves, and having perused his blog, I'm very happy to do so. His name is Chuck Cowdery, and you can find him at chuckcowdery.blogspot.com. And if you're not sure about the spelling, just go to ralphie.com, either Whisky Reviews or Whisky Stuff, and you'll find I've popped a link to his site. And another thing I'd like to mention before I go through my list of tasting notes is a number of you have commented that you'd like to see more time spent on tasting notes, the nosing and the tasting, and I'll do a wee bit more time, fair enough. 90 seconds, which was the last review, isn't a particularly long time, but I have to caution you and say beware of anybody's tasting notes, because you can get in the habit, my bourbon buddies, of getting yourself a bottle of bourbon or whiskey or whatever and saying, right, what do other people think about it? And if you're too busy checking out what other people think about it, you don't spend so much time checking it out from your own perspective. All tasting notes, all descriptions and smell and flavour are a guide, not the gospel, not facts. They are opinions and they are a useful guide, no more. And a useful guide relating to bourbon, we have Western Gold here. This is a bit off the radar, I'll come to that shortly. Bourbons, how do you classify a bourbon? A bourbon can only be made in the United States of America. Bourbon is a multigrain spirit made with a minimum of 51% corn, although, having said that, many respected bourbon makers use higher proportions, up to 70%. The other grains comprising a bourbon are usually wheat or barley and rye. The liquor is distilled to a maximum of 80% volume alcohol in the stills. There is no colour nor flavouring added. They don't have that 3% thing that the Canadians have. There's a bit more than that, actually. It is matured exclusively, bourbon is, in American white oak new-made casks, which are charred to varying degrees. and it enters the casks at no more than 62.5% alcohol, and when being bottled, it has to be an absolute minimum, like Scotch whisky, of 40%. After 3 months, some bourbons get bottled and sold, but after it's completed 2 years maturation, it can therefore be termed straight bourbon, not to be confused with straight whisky. If you ask for a straight whisky, you're going to get it on its own in the glass. Straight bourbon, you're going to get a matured bourbon. And any age statements in the bottle refer to the youngest liquor involved in that batch, just like, again, like Scotch whisky. And I think that's about it. Now, there's probably a few other little details, but these are the main criteria for bourbon. When is a bourbon not a bourbon? When it's a Tennessee whiskey. When it is a Tennessee whiskey, and there are two distillers that do it, it is in fact a bourbon, but it has some little individual finishing technique or production technique. And because it's Tennessee, and because the Tennessee folk like to be a little bit different, they call their bourbon whiskey. This bourbon bottle up is cheap as chips or fries if you're in the United States. It is probably one of the most reasonably priced bourbons on the market in Europe. It is sold by Lidl, the discount German supermarket. You can buy it for $6 in Germany. You can buy it for $10 in Britain. Now, does that mean because it's so cheap that it's bad bourbon? Not a bit of it. If you are on a budget, and it's something that's important to me as a commentator, I'm not doing all the fancy George T. Stagg reviews here. At $200 a bottle, I kid you not, that's how much they're expecting us to pay in Britain. $200 a bottle. I'm not paying that. I mean, it's good spirit, George T. Stagg, but it's not worth that. Whereas this, bang for your buck, it's got it. Nose. Again, I'm using my notes that I've been doing to keep me right. Nose is toffee, rye, strawberries and cream, cranberry, cola, tobacco, cigar, wee cigar note there. Touch of cherry cola and something else I couldn't put my finger on. I thought, what is that note? I remember it, but I can't name it. And then I did remember it. And this is what it is. Dandelion and burdock. Known in the United States of America as root beer. There has a little bit of the root beer about this on the nose and also in the taste. In the taste, and I'm going to add a wee drop of water, and I do recommend in this particularly reasonably priced bourbon that you, if you're going to buy it, put a drop of water in it, sit it with a cap on it, come back after 10 minutes and just see how much more the spirit has become. Now, there's quite a number of Western Golds out there. It is, in my opinion, it's Jim Beam. That's just my opinion. I'm not an expert, never will claim to be so. I don't have the expert's nose, but reminds me of previous tastings of Jim Beam. And it is a fact that the big producers do bottle under different labels. Do they bottle roughly the same whiskey stroke bourbon? Generally speaking, yes. Tasting. Lovely. Clean, sweet corn rye arrival with strawberry jam, tobacco, mixed spice and a very elegant, decent rose hip. Water with 5% releases complexity, floral, toffee, vanilla, chocolate and fudge, and a delicious finishing saltiness. Worth 85 out of 100. Bourbon Mark, nice to see ya. See ya soon.